The word mediocre, or another form of mediocrity means.
Right. Yes.
What do you say?
Regular.
Regular.
Normal.
Yeah. Okay. Serena?
Basic.
Ooh. Take one. Original person. That's not, I mean, close, but not quite. Amari?
Regular.
Average.
Huh?
Average.
Usual. Okay, let me tell you my definition of mediocrity. Mediocrity, or being mediocre, is when you settle for less when you can achieve greater.
Mm,
deep, right? Mm-hmm. Can a church say mm-hmm? Mm-hmm. Got Sister Jones in the back saying mm-hmm, child. Mm-hmm, child. Preach, preach. So, I want you guys to understand two things about what's about to happen. One, in your life, you have the opportunity and the ability to achieve whatever you set your mind to. Number two, never settle for less when you can achieve greater. Right here, I have a young lady who's sitting right next to me who is a shining example of achieving greater and not settling for less. Jordan, tell us a little bit about yourself. Tell us your name first.
Hi, I'm Jordan.
Yeah. It's not on. You didn't turn it.
I didn't know.
Check one.
It's for me.
Hi, I'm Jordan Davis. Shouts out to you.
Okay, this is Jordan Favors. Jordan, how old are you?
I'm 18.
Okay. Where will you be going in a couple weeks?
In less than a month, I'll be going to Pomona College in Claremont, California.
Okay. That seems like an expensive school, right? Ooh. How much is it per year?
It's about $65,000.
$65,000? That's a brand new Tesla.
What?
I want to be a Tesla. That's a brand new Tesla. Ooh. So, you have $65,000 on you?
No.
Does your mom have $65,000?
Oh, no.
Does your grandma have $65,000?
Yes, she did.
Does your neighbor across the street have $65,000?
I don't know them.
You don't know? Okay. So, you do not have $65,000, but how are you paying for school?
Scholarships.
What kind of scholarships?
A lot of them. I got a Horatio Alger scholarship,
mm-hmm.
Ben Carson scholarship,
mm-hmm.
Project Grant scholarship,
mm-hmm.
and the Gates Millennium scholarship.
The Gates Millennium. Now let me explain something to you about the Gates Millennium scholarship. Probably the most valuable scholarship in the land, okay? Now, Jordan, please explain to us how you got that scholarship.
So you have to, first, basics like qualify for a Pair Grant, like be a minority, have at least a 3.0 GPA, write like eight essays.
What grade is that?
Like write eight essays and then do you have to write out like all your volunteer experience, explain what you did, all your leadership experience, explain what you did, and all your extracurricular activities.
Yeah.
Explain what those were.
Quick question, Jordan, where did you grow up, like your early childhood years?
Early childhood years, I grew up in Four Seasons.
Four Seasons?
Yeah.
Like Four Seasons by the penitentiary?
Yeah.
Huh. How many of our kids come from Four Seasons? Hmm. That's interesting. So, tell us a little about your experience growing up in that neighborhood.
Okay, my experience is a little different from the kids now because as far as I heard, it's gotten worse. I moved when I was about, I think I was going into junior high. But it wasn't all that, like, it was mostly low-income housing. I stayed with my mom and my brother, that was just us. And, yeah, it wasn't an ideal place to live. Yeah, it got dangerous as like the years came on. So
tell me about what are your goals? What are your aspirations in life?
My plans are to become an OBGYN and then later on my own practice.
Okay. So you want to be the babies?
Yes.
Ooh. Interesting, interesting. One of the greatest professions in the world, if I must say to myself, right behind preaching.
Of course.
Okay, that's interesting. You want to tell us to share a little bit more about, you know, what's going on with you and, you know, your spiritual walk with God and how God has empowered you over the years?
So, like, a lot of you got baptized when you were young. I got baptized when I was young at my grandma's church. And ever since then, I, you know, always knew about Jesus and what have you. But I wouldn't say I've been living, you know, the Christian way all the time. But I can't say that my walk with God or my spiritual growth has really increased over time, because I've seen that what he could do for me, like bring me out of what I came from, because my life wasn't easy, you know, and we went through a lot of trials and tribulations, but I just see that he can bring me out because he's offered me, like, he's done great things for me. I moved from a school that I just thought was, like, the greatest, but ended up having to go to a school that I hate. But I still end up doing well, graduated, like, valedictorian with 3.9 in my class and stuff, and thank you. So he just really has helped me and just like been there for me and just let me know through different things. Like, some people say they hear him, but I was like, I never can hear him. I don't, you know. But he shows me that he's always there for me and he'll never let me down, because he keeps like proving me that like he's always there. Because I went to a program at Princeton like last summer for like 7 weeks, and that's when he really showed me like I can do stuff. Like, I didn't believe in myself, and then even coming from there, those kids, like, they were low income, but like their school system was way better than mine. So even though I got into the program, I still didn't like feel like I was worthy to do anything. And then senior year, he just showed me that I can do like above and beyond, because what Bo's mad at me now about. I got into Duke, and I didn't go to Duke. I got into Columbia, didn't go to Columbia, got into Johns Hopkins, and like got into all those schools. He really showed me that I was worth it and that I could be what I want to be. And so like, he's just really proving himself. And then even this week, I just really have grown in God, because I didn't really pick up the Bible like that, but I find myself here like constantly reading and reading. Like, the lessons that's been going on this week, it was ironic, because that's the book I was reading right now, which was Mark. So he's just really been there for me, and I'm like really thankful for all he's done.
If you had to tally up a total amount of scholarships and dollar amount, how much would you estimate?
Well, last time I heard it was $2.7 million.
$2.7 million. Amen. Give a hand clap, Dr.